What do you do here all day? You just grab your little chips and your little chip marker there and just mark them down? I mean, this is kind of a pathetic job. Let me try that. Okay, fine. Nice steal, bud. So, well, here, might as well go with some more. We managed to rake in 1,100 this week. Don't come again! I don't know, I think we can go so much further with this.
What are you talking about, Brian?
Theo, you're a popcorn bitch at the Camelot Theater. And James, your pay rate's a joke as a bouncer at Coconut Joe's. I mean, you guys can't tell me you're all right with your lives right now. I mean, the kicker is, we still live with our parents.
Well, this is the crew. Yeah, probably not what you would expect for a group of criminal masterminds. Okay, maybe not criminal mastermind, but we were actually well-seasoned in the art of thievery. Of course, just small-time stuff. My life was pretty dull, but thanks to these guys, I could get a rush at least once in a while.
You miscount that money, I swear I'll slap you so hard your firstborn will come out with his head on backwards.
When have I ever miscounted the money?
That goes for you, too.
Please. If anybody ever dreamed of laying hands on me, you better wake up and apologize.
I think I figured out a way for us to make enough money to where we don't have to worry about our pathetic jobs. We finally move out of our parents' houses. But it's gonna require a little more out of all of us.
What did you have in mind?
All right, so it's like this. Remember that little...
And there went Brian again. I admit, my life was pathetic, and Brian's proposal was appealing. But were we ready for something bigger?
Hey, hold on a sec, okay?
I know, Ma. I already took the dog out and vacuumed the living room. No, I'm not getting any cold with you. I just gotta go. Theo's here. Yes, I know. Your house, your rules. No, I won't be home for dinner.
I can't do this anymore, bro.
I cannot wait until next month. This shit just ain't gonna do. What other 26-year-old rubs his mother's feet every night?
Yeah, about next month. I don't know if I can do it, man. I mean, this is like nothing we've ever done before. This is way over our heads.
That's exactly why we're doing this. So we can move on. Aren't you sick of other people running your life?
Yeah. But like this?
Look, don't sweat it, kid. Pretty soon, we'll be looking back on this and having one big laugh. And when it's all said and done, you'll be the one calling the shots. No one else.
Something. Evening, son.
Who the hell are you?
Sam. Name's Sam. How you doing? What in the heck is bothering you, son?
Makes you think something's bothering me.
Oh, I don't know. You're surrounded by bottles over there. You're drinking alone. It looks like a whole fucking party to me.
Who gives a shit how much I drink?
I don't care how much you drink. You just don't look like an alcoholic, that's all.
Look, I'm gonna be honest, old man. I don't know why you care about me so much. Frankly, it's kind of creeping me out. My business is my business.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I'm just suggesting, at least with me, for example, when I got a problem, it's nice to talk it out, and I can help you if you want, or at least listen.
Listen, I thought I had a problem, but I don't. There's something I have to do, and that's that. There's not a damn thing I can do about it.
Why?
Why what?
Well, why can't you do something about it?
Because if I don't, then I'll be stuck in the shithole I call my life.
Okay.
God, why am I even talking to you? You have no idea what I'm going through.
I'm sorry. Here, honey, this is for our drinks over here. I got nothing. I don't know what you're going through, right? Let me tell you something, buddy. Whatever you do in this life, you take a drink, you take a shit, you rob a bank, I don't know, whatever it is you do, you're responsible for. You ultimately are responsible for it. I gotta get out of here.
Whatever.
Hey, listen. Maybe I'll see you around, all right?
What's up, Brian?
Nothing, just calling to check up on you.
You all right, man?
Yeah. Sorry,
All right, I'm just calling to see if you're ready for tomorrow.
Yeah. About tomorrow. I can't do it, man. No. It's actually a pretty funny story. I met this guy named Sam.